All right, welcome everyone to today's webinar on the Macrium Technicians and Deployment Kit tools. We've had quite a few people ask for webinars like this, and we've been loading them up onto our YouTube channel. So today, like I mentioned, we're going over the Technicians and Deployment Kit tools. My name is Leif Tornberg. I'm the Inside Sales Manager for the United States, and I also have Jack Mansfield on here. He's with our technical support team. He's going to be running the demo to actually show off how these work. So what I'll be taking you through is Macrium at a glance, just give you a brief overview of Macrium. I'll take you through the technician's license, the portable application media that comes with it, and the deployment kit software. And then we'll go through a demo with Jack, and then we can cover any other products that you might be interested in, along with a Q&A session. So Macrium. Macrium Reflect is an image-based backup and cloning solution that's used for commercial and for home use. We have over 8 million downloads worldwide, allowing you to protect your data, upgrade any hard drive or hardware, and clone your operating systems. To go over real quick, I just want to mention what we went over in previous webinars. We've gone over cloning, so how it can replicate complete volume disks and the structures of these disks to another device, allowing the target disk to be identical to the original device. It contains duplicates of all volumes, so everything contained on the device, and allows you to clone files, operating systems, applications, user profiles, pretty much everything. And you can swap out failed disks for really fast DR there. We went over disk imaging. It creates a direct copy of disks and partitions, and it saves it as an image file. This contains a complete copy of these disks and partitions, so you can get things like system partitions and everything like that. And these image files can be mounted for file and folder recovery. And you can also move these image files around for other recovery needs and DR. We did go over some advanced features such as Image Guardian, which is our ransomware protection. We went over Rapid Delta Cloning, Rapid Delta Restore, VI Boot. This is the ability to boot a image into a virtual interface for another fast DR solution. We have change block tracking and our Macrium redeploy. That's what allows you to send the image over to dissimilar hardware. So if you're moving from different types of devices, that kind of thing. So the technician's license, what is it exactly? It's a tool for IT professionals to use for at-will imaging and recovery of their PCs and their servers. It uses the Macrium Reflect imaging engine on a portable application that you can run on a USB drive within the Windows PE or RE environments. This is great for hardware upgrades or hardware replacements. So if you're swapping out drives or swapping out devices, this is great for mass imaging of that, so you can do it very quickly rather than manually loading between devices. This avoids the need to install Macrium on each individual device. It just stays on that portable application, so you can just run through and backup and restore as need be. That portable application media, how does it work exactly? Well, this is created from the Macrium Reflect server license. It's a special license key that gets installed and adds in the ability to create this portable version. You use a USB drive used within the PE or RE environment to just run that portable version from the USB drive. This can boot dev machines with the USB drive by just telling them to boot directly from USB and allows you to install or recover an image to it. This can only deploy an image to a newer replacement machine. It is not meant for deploying an image to multiple devices. That's where our deployment kit comes in. This is our created, we created this as a replacement or alternative for older versions of Ghost because it's not being updated as much, and we want to add it in our own product. This is based off the technician's license, but it allows the unlimited deployment of master images, and you can create as many as you need as well. It has pull deployment, and it allows the creation of up to 5 USB sticks that you can create and deploy images with, and you can also deploy over the network via Pixi. And this is an extremely popular tool that is utilized by quite a few different companies. So comparing the two, as you've seen, they are relatively similar, but there's a big major difference, which is that deployment. So both can back up files and folders. They can run incremental differential schedule backups, and they can encrypt the backups with that Image Guardian. They both have the ransomware protection, like I mentioned, Image Guardian, and they can they can encrypt your backups with password protection too. It allows for the bare metal restore to dissimilar hardware with our redeploy feature. You could do direct cloning, rapid delta cloning, and restore, and so you can still have quick DR with these products. These both take a snapshot image of your PC without actually having to install Macrium on those devices, so they're still portable applications. And only the deployment kit is what allows you to deploy a golden image to more than one device using that USB or Pixie. So just to summarize, these tools are ideal for technicians that work in large environments where they need to maintain large quantities of machines with a very similar configuration or multiple configurations across different departments. So like call centers, universities, retail branches, anyone that has large amounts of devices that, you know, can use a lab refresh or have a large number of new incoming devices. This allows to enable flexible imaging and restoration, which minimizes maintenance and downtime per machine. So this really takes your tech off the floor and lets him go work on other projects rather than spending all his time, you know, imaging and deploying to these machines. This increases availability by reducing the risk of overrunning maintenance on Windows. It can lift the technician's productivity and cut overall IT maintenance costs. So a few case studies we can go through. The Pasco Learning and Activity Centers of Enrichment, they said it just works. They found the deployment kit incredibly easy to use and were able to push out all their images in less than 10 minutes. So it's extremely fast for large amounts of devices. They used the deployment kit and were able to deploy to a large number of computers over a network. It just took 30 minutes and the interface made the solution very easy to use for them. They also loved our support team. They said they were on hand to answer our questions, no matter how small they were. Being an education supplier, they really appreciated the fact that they got an educational discount as well. And so they loved the price, they loved the product, and just everything was great. Severn Trent Water, they loved us as well. They said one of our best features has to be the speed. So just like the last company, they're loving how fast Macrium actually works. So suddenly even the largest images can be backed up and restored incredibly quickly, more than twice as fast as their previous supplier. So they're using the deployment kit in their organization, which allows them the power of Macrium's technician's license to create the images and the deployment kit to actually send those images out over their enterprise. So a single user can now image multiple servers and PCs with a singular product very quickly. They said we wouldn't hesitate to recommend Macrium to other businesses, and they love the fact that Macrium is a British homegrown product. So now I'm going to turn things over to Jack and let him run through the demo.
That's great, thank you.
I just made you presenter, Jack, so you should be able to share your screen here.
So, as Leif mentioned before, I'll be giving a quick run through of how to actually create your technician's media. So we'll break this down into two parts. There's the actual portable application itself, which is run from the USB within Windows, and then in the event of disaster, you can boot it into the PE or RE environment to perform system recovery if you're not able to boot into Windows. So as ever, we start with the backup tab here, which is what you'll be presented with when you open Reflect. But today we'll be focusing on the other tasks menu and more specifically the Create Rescue Media. So most of you will have seen this before when you're creating your rescue media just inside Reflect as normal. But there are a couple of key differences here. So since we're inside a virtual machine at the minute, there's no USB option, but if you had a USB or CD drive attached to your computer, these options would also be presented here. But recently, the option to create technicians' ISOs has also been added, which is useful for ad hoc imaging of virtual machines, much in the same way you would a physical computer. So to start with here, we'll have a look at a couple of the more advanced options. So the first option you have is to actually choose the WIM, which your rescue media will be built on. So as a rule of thumb, we try and recommend using Windows RE. This is due to it having Wi-Fi support, which allows you to access network resources if you don't have a wired connection. And also it comes built into your operating system, Windows 7 and above, I believe. So this won't require any further download of the PE files from Microsoft. However, there are a few other options here as well. Each one is built on a different operating system. So Windows PE 10 here, which is the most up-to-date version of PE. So that will include the most driver support. So as a rule of thumb, if you're not using RE, you want to be using PE 10 because it will have the most driver support, such as USB 3. But if you're having issues, you can select the PE build that's based on the operating system that you're installing. You also have a few more options here, such as adding BitLocker support, so BitLocker drives automatically unlock when you're booting into Rescue Media, and the architecture of the Rescue Media that you're creating. We also have the ability to use a custom-based WIM here if you're using a pre-prepared Windows image file. Next, we have the devices and drivers here, which you can use to add further drivers that might not be natively supported by Windows PE. So suppose you wanted to add something like an NVMe driver, you could do that here. And we have the location where the files for these are stored on your operating system. Okay. So the next option we want to check is the Create Portable Technicians Rescue Media down here. This is what is the difference between creating a normal rescue media and actually creating your technician's rescue media. And then after this, you'd select build and it will create your rescue media. However, we've done this beforehand. So if we close out of this, this is once you've created your technician's rescue media and it's been inserted, this is what you'll be presented with. And the option we want to look at here is the portable exe. If we select this, this will launch the portable Reflect application. So this is what makes it perfect for ad hoc images and restores. So a good example I like to give is if you're running a computer tech shop and someone brings a computer that they want repairing, you don't want to be putting software onto their computer. But at the same time, you want an image so that if something does go wrong, you can restore it back to the state it was in when it was given to you. So this is perfect for that example because all you do is insert your rescue media, take an image, and then if anything happens, you can restore back to it. So once you've loaded up your technician's portable application here, you can add drivers to it. So in that example, they brought in a computer. You insert this technician's license and do add drivers to technician's rescue media. And this will add any drivers that aren't natively supported by PE again. So that you know if an issue does occur with that computer, when you boot into the rescue environment to restore Windows, all of the devices will have support. So once you've finished doing this, you can also do ad hoc images and restores using this here. So suppose using the deployment license example, you could boot this onto a machine and perform your restores that way. So next, we'll take a quick look at the actual rescue media itself here. So if there is a disaster that you need to recover from on your computer, you'd insert your rescue media, boot into the rescue environment here, and then you can perform your restore. You can navigate to a network share if you have your images located there. It is also possible, as Leif mentioned briefly earlier, to take the WIM out of the rescue media and then add it to a Windows deployment server so that you can PXE boot it if you don't want to be booting it from an actual USB itself. So that's just another way to make it even easier to perform the restores. We won't cover that fully now. However, there are articles on our knowledge base for that. So with that, I'll pass it back to Leif and answer any questions that might be at the end.
Great. Thanks, Jack. Let me share my screen back over. All right, so we did have one question that was related to if we run any promos on this. So at the moment, we do have an active promo running for the deployment kit, which goes until September 1st, 2019. It's a 3 month deployment kit at a quarter of the cost. So it gives you 3 months of the deployment kit, and then it really with a lot of education customers in mind, where they do just summer refreshes, but they have a lower budget. So this is a great product to bring in just for their summer use. If it is something they wish to continue using afterward, they can renew it for the full year at renewal cost once their 3 months is up. One more we had is this going to be recorded and available? So yes, this will be. It'll be available on our YouTube channel along with our other ones. So we're going to have a whole series of webinars that'll be available on our YouTube channel, our Macrium YouTube channel. And I think that's all the questions we have for now. If you guys have any other questions, feel free to reach out directly to your Macrium rep. You could just give us a call in the here in the US or in Britain as well. So like I said, any questions, feel free to field that directly to us. We're always happy to help. That being said, I do want to briefly cover a couple other products we have available. If you want more in-depth demos of these products, again, reach out to your Macrium rep. They'll be more than happy to run a demo for you, or at least put you in the right place and get your questions answered. We do have a site manager software. This is our remote management tool that gets installed on site. You can actually come in and deploy agents from here. You can set up all your backup schedules, repositories, pretty much everything you need to do Macrium, aside from the technicians and deployment kit, can be done here, because these are more for our products that get installed locally on devices. The multi-site manager, this links to your site manager and allows you to remotely control multiple networks from a single location. So you can actually remote it into separate site managers and control multiple clients' networks. Like I mentioned before, you can find our previous webinar videos on our Macrium Reflect YouTube channel. So feel free to give us a look up and check out the other webinars and how-to guides that we have available here. So that's everything we had for you today. Thanks for joining, everyone, and have a great day.